I didn't know what to expect from this setup, but 5 minutes in, I was hooked. This is how you go from, that looks good, to, hey, what movie is that from? A straight inside Blender, no extra software. Delicious colors, full creative control, renders that actually look finished. Stick around and by the end of the video, you'll know exactly how to build it, tweak it, and make every single render pop. I'm Dude Blender, and let's jump right in. Alright, I'm opening up my Yoshi's Island scene, and I'm gonna give it a quick render so that we have something to work with. Let's go to the compositing workspace, click on Use Nodes. Blender gives us two nodes to begin with, render layers and composite. That's your raw render straight out of Cycles or Eevee, and composite is your final output. Shift A, Viewer, or just Control Shift left click on any node to preview it. Some people like the backdrop, I'm not a big fan, so I'm just gonna disable this thing, and I prefer to use an image editor panel here on the right. And if it's not already, we need to set this here to Viewer node. Bonus tip, if you're on a second monitor, you can drag out this panel and float it, and now you can place it anywhere you want, even on your second monitor. Of course, for the tutorial, I just want to leave it here. Here's where the magic happens, layer passes. In this tab, all of these are the ingredients of your final image, but by default, you cannot decide how much of each is gonna go into your final mix. Check denoising data, and down here, enable all of the light passes except Shadow Catcher. Now look at your Render Layers node. It's sprouted tentacles. Each socket is a separate render layer pass. Control Shift click on the node to preview the different passes. If nothing shows up, hit Render again. Passes only appear if they were active during the render. Now we can see what each ingredient is contributing to the final image. Now the Blender manual gives us the recipe to build the image from these passes. Direct plus indirect, multiply by the color, and then add everything together. Let's build the diffuse section. Shift A, mix, mix color, set it to add, connect diffuse direct and diffuse indirect, duplicate the node, Shift D, change it to multiply, reconnect the add result, and diffuse color. Control Shift click, and boom, you've got your diffuse passes reconstructed. Here's a fun trick to try out. Let's drop in another mix node and connect it to the diffuse direct noodle. We're gonna change this to multiply, and now we can use the color, specifically the value of the color, to control the amount of that specific ingredient. Completely white equals full strength, and completely black means that we've effectively disabled that layer pass. If we want a glowy image like this, we can reduce it. If we want to tint it, well, we can go ahead and do that. Now you're playing with power. I mean, Blender power. I'm just gonna delete the node, and this is a pro tip. If you just press X, the noodles that were connected to the node that you deleted are also gone. But if you select it and press Control X, the node just gets removed, but the rest of the connection is still there. Let's keep building. We duplicate this setup with Shift D for the glossy direct, glossy indirect, and gloss color. Now we want to add these two results, so Control Shift right click and drag between them to auto create a mix node. Expand this and set to add. So we got our diffuse input and our gloss input. Now in this setup, if we want less gloss, we can drop the factor. And if we want more gloss, we can just Alt S to switch the inputs and then dial it down. You can start seeing the power of this setup. Let me wire the rest in real quick. And just keep in mind that Eevee and Cycles have different setups. This one's for Cycles. So if you wanted to use Eevee, you would need to build the Eevee setup. You also may have noticed noise in the image. We'll fix that later. And if this looks like a lot of work, it kind of is. That's why the full finished node group is up on Gumroad for $2.99, which, fun fact, is less than $3. And if you want the island for your test renders, I'll put it up for $5 and a bundle of the nodes and island for 6 doubloons. All right, once we're done here, Shift A, denoise, and toss it at the end. Connect denoising normal and denoising albedo. Now check your work. The image out of the full composite, so out of this node, should look exactly the same as this image, which we can check by Control Shift clicking. If we don't see any change at all, it means that our setup is correct. Let's spice up those shadows. Shift A, mix, place it before denoising the image, and let's plug in ambient occlusion, AO. One pro tip here is that whenever your trees start getting too big, you need to zoom out, and then everything starts to become very small. And if you don't want to be zooming in and zooming out, you can just Shift Alt, right click, and drag between between the nodes that you want to connect, and then you'll get the menus from socket. So we select what socket on the first node we want to connect, so ambient occlusion, what socket we want to connect it to in the second node. In this case, it's the image. Change the mix to multiply. Let's preview this. Drop the factor to 0.1 for softer shadows or 0.3 for crispier shadows. This will depend on the image that you're rendering and, of course, on your personal taste. All right, we've got our vase, but this is a noodle soup.
Noodle soup.
And we want sushi clean and contained. Select all of these nodes. We're leaving out the ambient occlusion multiply and the denoiser. Control G to group everything. Inside the group node, we'll add a multiply after each input socket. And we're gonna use the second input of the multiply node as a control. And in this panel, we scroll down all the way and we're going to rename each one. Diffuse, direct, which we can now see here. Then diffuse indirect, glossy direct, glossy indirect, etc. I'm just gonna go ahead and do that and then come back. Done. This is the setup of the group. Now, if we jump out of the node, we have a compact and fully tweakable group node. This is next level control. I'm gonna render this. Now, I just wanna make sure that I connected everything correctly. So this image, the output of our composite, and this image should look exactly the same. No add-ons, no scripts, just Blender. Full control over every single ingredient. Environment's too bright. Okay. Value, 0.5. Environment's not bright enough. Okay. Value, 2. Transmission, too dull. Okay. Transmission indirect, value, 3. Emission, not bright enough. Okay. Emission, value. What about 5? Too much. Okay. 2. Remember that in the colors, if you click and drag on value, you can just go from 0 to 1. But if you click, you can type any number that you want. If you want to tint it, then you can just select any color that you like. You call the shots. And note that if you hover over the color and press backspace, it reverts to the default white. Let's spice this up a notch. Shift A, filter, glare. Let's say we want to add stars just to the glossy direct pass. Pipe it here, change this from streaks to simple star, and maybe change the threshold to 0.6. What about a cinematic halo on the lava emission? You duplicate the glare node, connect it to emission or emit. It's easy to know what noodle you're gonna connect this to because it turns white. Set this to fog glow, threshold to 0.1 for a soft velvety halo. And if you want to actually see the effect, select the node M to turn it off and turn it on back again. Here's another trick. The denoiser takes a while, and everything you change here passes through the denoiser again. So if you don't need it, you might want to disable it so that you can see your changes faster, and then once you're finished, you can just go back to the denoise and turn it back on. Okay, couple extra things just to make it that much better. Shift A, color, color balance. Plug it in after everything. Switch it to offset power slope. If you want moody shadows, power up. And let's give it a blue tint. And keep in mind that this wheel works in the opposite way that you would think. So if you want blue shadows, you want to move this to the oranges. And if you want to make it darker, you need to slide this up, not down. I am actually going to mute the denoiser. Now, if you want punchy highlights, we boost the slope and we go warm. I'm going to throw in an RGB curves right before this one and tweak to taste. This is your very own color grading suite inside Blender. All right, final step, a little bit of chaos. Shift A, distort, lens distortion. Pipe it at the end. Perfect renders are boring, so let's break it just a little bit. Let's connect the viewer so that we can see it here. Click on fit, distortion to 0.01, dispersion to 0.02. This gives a tiny bit of chromatic edge shift like real lenses do. Pro tip, don't overdo it. Even as low as 0.1 starts looking pretty bad. Stuff like this doesn't look very pro. So keep it between 0.01 and maybe 0.03. Let me get the denoiser back on. I'm just gonna go to 0.02. That's the spot, chef's kiss. If you got the Gumroad file, I added a touch of blur, grain, and a soft vignette for that final and very special polish. Everything's neat and tidy, and even in the grain and vignette, I added a few controls so that you can get the exact look that you want. Final thing, save it forever. This is a lot of work, and maybe you've dialed in a style that you like and you want to continue using on your future renders. But as far as I know, you cannot just copy this and then go to a different file compositing, use nodes, and paste it here. Clipboard's empty. Something that we can do is select all of these nodes and group them. So this is what we get. Now we save the file. Now we go to our new file, File, Append, open the file with the complete node tree, and you'll be able to see all of the information. Scroll down to node tree and open the node that we just created. Now Shift A, and the name of the group was node group, so node group, enter, and we get this node. Now we can open the node, copy all of this, go back out, paste it. We can get rid of this one. And now in our new file, we want to uncheck denoise because we don't need it. We are denoising with this node. Go to view layer properties and enable the passes that we did before. So denoising data, all of these except shadow catcher. And we just connect these. Our ambient occlusion to here, denoising normal here, denoising albedo here, and this one to our composite. Just organize this a little bit. And now we have our setup. Let's uncheck backdrop. Here, select view node. And now we can just go back to layout. And now we can go to file, defaults, save startup file. The reason I needed to do that is that I am working on my Yoshi's Island file so that I have a scene to show you what happens when I make all of these changes. The thing is that if I go file, defaults, and save this startup file, then every time I open a new Blender file, I'll get this island, and that's not something that you want. And there you go, a fully modular, professional-grade post-processing setup built entirely inside Blender. If you want the file, it's on Gumroad. If you want to flex your node skills, now you know how to do this. And now that you've seen this, good luck ever going back to vanilla renders. I'm Dude Blender. Happy Blender.